The clinical trials that take place at Building 10 are often the product of years of painstaking work. Researchers test their methods in the laboratory and in animals before finally getting approval from review boards.
No clinical trial gets started without a lot of oversight and a lot of eyes looking over. Is the science rigorous? Is it have social value?
Different perspectives come to the table, doctors, nurses, bioethicists, lawyers, making sure that the risks are acceptable and not excessive.
And then at some point, it gets approved. After all that happens, there's many, many moments, particularly when you're about to treat the first patient, where, you know, you lose sleep.
So first of all, this is an experimental protocol, and there's certainly a lot of unknowns about this. I'm optimistic, but it's hard to say that in the context of a trial that we've got limited experience with.
Sounds good.
All right.
There's always a bit of an ethical, you know, conflict.
We only want to enroll patients that, in fact, have exhausted all other possibilities.
It's inherently a vulnerable patient population. They're desperate. We have to ensure as investigators that they understand the risk and they understand that there's nothing to say for sure that it's going to work. I'm hopeful, but I have nothing to say it's going to work.
At this point, we've completed all the evaluations and everything indicates that you're eligible, you know, for the study.
Mm-hmm.
Assuming, you know, you agree to it.
Well, I didn't do all this not to agree.
I know.
The last 5 years have been like a roller coaster ride, but I have a lot of hope that this is going to be it, that this is going to be the miracle for my boy and for those to come after him.
All right.
We're in.
In the big leagues.
Since Building 10 opened more than a half century ago, over 500,000 patients have been enrolled in clinical trials, treated and studied free of charge. Some, like Bo Cooper, have well-known illnesses that have resisted all standard care. Others have rare diseases that are mysteries.
We flew in just for today.
Where are you from?
Texas.
Yeah. Wow.
And there are those, like Deidra Williams, whose disease has been neglected by the medical community.
This is our typical NIH consent. It just lets you know that this is a research study and everything's entirely voluntary. Mm-hmm. It's experimental, and then you're being screened to determine your eligibility because you have a blood disorder, sickle cell disease.
If you agreed, you would initial this top line.
I agree. Blood drive.
Deidra suffers from sickle cell disease.
I can pull up the schedule.
A deadly genetic disorder that afflicts millions around the world, predominantly those of African descent.
When sickle cell strikes, the red blood cells, normally round or donut-shaped, become crescent or sickle-shaped under the microscope.
Sickle cell was first identified in 1910. And in the century since, little progress has been made in finding a cure.
For years, testing, screening, and research has been largely neglected. Most who get sickle cell die before 40. Many succumb even before 20.
Even today, with all the advances in medical science, adults with sickle cell still have no standard cure.
We've known about sickle cell disease now for a century. I every now and then I have to think a little bit. You know, a century is 100 years, and to this day, you know, there's only one medication that's approved for sickle cell pain. Really, nothing else.
My liver is inflamed, possibly some scarring. To having sickle cell for 43 years, kind of par for the course.
Sickle cell disease causes a malformation in red blood cells, The very cells that carry oxygen to every organ in the body. In most of us, red blood cells are soft and round. But in patients with this disease, some are hard and shaped like a sickle.
So the regular cell can make its way through the circulation with no problem at all. Easily squeeze through narrow blood vessels and get all the way around the circulation and back to the lung. But sickled cells, they get clogged up and they stop the blood flow in an area that needs oxygen. And that causes excruciating pain and relentless damage to all of the organs in the body. And as a consequence, their lifespan is remarkably shortened.